Bari Saab rang me a couple of weeks ago and said that can I give a talk on the status of cardiac surgery in Pakistan? And I was thinking how to go about this thought, but then...
This one? Okay.
And I put up a few slides. I would like to dedicate this talk to Professor S.M. Rab. I knew him for a very long time, because I was a student, so I knew him as a teacher, then as a mentor, and then he was known to me as a patient, and he was very proud to tell to everybody that I operated on him. Then I thought that one day his heart will give way and take his life, but that didn't happen. He died because of brain cancer, as you might have read in the newspaper. And we have already offered Fatiha for him. Incidentally, when I made this talk, I wanted to give, I was choosing the theme, and I struck a black background, and I just stuck to that. Before I start on a status of cardiac surgery in Pakistan, I would like you to look at this picture of the world. This is a satellite picture of the world taken at night. And what you can see is that there are some bright areas, very illuminated, and there are dark areas like Africa, like Asia, and the bright areas are America, some part of India, Europe, parts of Australia. And you will find this difference of in distribution, in illumination, in our life every day. There are privileged people and there are not so privileged people. And this is because of the fact that 80% of the world wealth is shared by 20% of the world population. Aur baki jo bichare 80% दुनिया के रहने वाले हैं उनके पास दुनिया की वेल्थ का सिर्फ 20% है इसकी वजह से क्या हो रहा है लेट्स लुक एट द कार्डियक सर्जरी इन द वर्ल्ड दिस आर द नंबर ऑफ ऑपरेशंस पर मिलियन इन नॉर्थ अमेरिका 1,222 द अदर एंड इज अफ्रीका ओनली 18 पर मिलियन पॉपुलेशन And there are a lot of papers about that. And if you compare, then there's one center on 120,000 population. And in Africa, only one center for 33 million people in Africa. When we come to Pakistan, we are a very brave nation. But this is the Newsweek title, When the Flood came in August, yes, it is actually 6 September 2010. But we have not learned lesson and we are still standing there in the flood situation. So we have to learn lessons and move forward. When I look at cardiac surgery in Pakistan, I just divided it into three main headings. The clinical work, the training of cardiac surgery, and the research in cardiac surgery. When we think about clinical work, then we have to look at the disease spectrum of our country. Is it different? Yes, it is. Is it different from the rest of the world? We have to look what hospitals we have, why, and what are the challenges in clinical practice. Well, the disease spectrum of cardiac disease is well described by World Health Organization. And they published this Atlas of the Heart Disease and Stroke. And it shows the red area in this map, where Pakistan is also included, as a high prevalence area for rheumatic heart disease. So we see lots and lots of rheumatic valvular heart disease. Whereas in the developed world, only 2% of their work is now related to rheumatic heart disease. And that's why they get away by repairing more and more valves than us. If you look at the global burden of coronary heart disease, again, we are in the high range. In this map, India is certainly higher than us, but I think that is because of some lack of data. But this was put up by WHO. And I just want to focus on two of the things which are mentioned in the chart, and I'll just zoom and enlarge those for you. One is that the coronary heart disease burden is projected to rise from around 47 million DALI years globally in 1990 to about 82 million DALI. Now, what is DALI? DALI is the major the disability adjusted life years. This is the measurement of how much time you are losing. Main ek misal de deta hu. Agar meri zindagi expected mere jaise logon ki 60 saal hai aur agar main 50 saal mein meri wafat ho jaye to 10 DALI year jo hain wo lost ho gaye. Aur agar koi aisi procedure kiya jaye jisse wo 1 saal bach jaye aur uski cost calculate kiya jaye to wo DALI years ki cost aa jati hai. That is how the finance in health is now calculated. Look at the second part which I zoomed here, that more than 60% of global burden of coronary heart disease is occurring in the developing countries. So these are the challenges which we face. Now, to cope with all this, we have cardiac hospitals, and the cardiac hospitals are of two types in our country. Ek to government ho gaye, private ho gaye, but there's another classification. And cardiac units within general hospital like Aga Khan Hospital is a multi-speciality hospital, National Medical Center, South City, Civil Hospital, Indus Hospital, these are all multi-speciality hospital. And the second category of hospitals are those which are from small to large freestanding units like Armed Forces Institute of Cardiology in Islamabad, Tabba, NICVD in Karachi. Does it make difference? And I discuss this point here because it does. That there are several papers. This one is the Specialty Cardiac Hospital, how special are they? Retained circulation, there's another one. Looking at the outcome of acute myocardial infarction and congestive heart failure at a specialty hospital. Now what is the difference? The difference is that all this paper conclude one thing. That the patient admitted to a specialty hospital had better outcome marginally for acute myocardial infarction and congestive heart failure than general hospital. But, and this is a big but, general hospitals were admitting more sicker patients. So I think that fact gets diluted by the notion that in a multi-speciality hospital you are treating patients with chronic obstructive airway disease with neurological issues and renal issues, whereas you are not addressing those in a specialty hospital. But there are certain pros and cons of either of the system. In a general hospital, you get very sick patients, they can be treated, patients with many comorbids and multidisciplinary teams are available. But there are some downsides, that the geographically patients are scattered all over the place. So because of that, safety may get compromised. The more time consumed per nursing and medical act, and the patients are mixed, so risk of cross-infection is there, and lack of specialty nursing care. But what are the cons? That going on further, that patient's care processes are difficult to implement, services fragmented and hampered with the flow of care and lack of integration. There is no autonomy for the program, and the patient may get dissatisfied because of that. In the specialty hospital, the pros are that the focused care is available, reduced cost of care is available, high patient satisfaction, they offer physician better control over management and decision making. But the downsides, if you look at those, then specialty hospital competition threatens the ability of general hospital to cross-subsidize less profitable service and patients. And a small hospital do not admit emergencies and very sick patients, some of the very small hospital. And if you look at the challenges in the practice of cardiac surgery, then cardiac surgery, as you know, is an expensive business. It requires monitoring, a lot of medical and surgical supplies. You buy equipment which may be very expensive, require periodic checkups and depreciate with time. So the aim and the biggest challenge in Pakistan is how to reduce the cost. And this can be done with bulk purchases, better negotiation, competition, and bulk purchases even at national level, which we have done in Tissue Well, for example. And we are only use FDA-approved products. As far as the surgical practice is concerned, then there are challenges like valvular ischemic surgery, congenital heart surgery, and the issue of cardiac transplantation. So I've shown you that incidence, and this is the own study done by in Karachi, done by Dr. Abdul Samad, and the rheumatic heart disease is endemic in Pakistan. Incidence is 5.7 patients per 1,000 population. And this is a study comparing the valvular heart surgery practice between Africa and Europe, and we are very close to that. You see that in the blue line is the practice of heart valve operations in Europe. And you can see that they require surgery. Sorry, this was the red line. Most of the patients require, because they don't have rheumatic heart disease, they have degenerative heart disease, they require surgery when they reach to the age of 50 to 79 and peaking at about 60 to 65. Whereas in our country, we require surgery very early, and that keeps on going. And when we replace this is another huge challenge, that when we replace the valve, we replace it with either mechanical or tissue valve. None is as good as the patient's own native valve. And because of that, we take one valve out and give a prosthetic valve disease to the patient. And I'm just cutting short because I have to go for a condolence meeting for Professor Rabeh starting at 11. So there are various issues of anticoagulation and warfarin. As you know, that is a bad thing. It's a very difficult thing to monitor the INR. In ischemic heart disease, the challenges are that we get younger age group. They are mostly diabetic, hypertensive. About 40 to 60% of the patients in various reports from Pakistan are diabetic when they present for coronary artery disease. And I think you have to look at this line, which is the study by WHO. And it is published in the American Heart Journal, that one in four middle-aged adults in Pakistan has prevalent coronary artery disease. And there is reference to that in the American Heart Journal. Surgery on aorta, another procedure that is again challenging because of late presentation, late diagnosis, and full range of grafts are not available. They are very expensive. And the future, I think, will be in TAVI, TVAR, and those sort of procedures which are done percutaneously. But the cost is so exorbitant that right now they are not practiced in this country. This is an elephant trunk, which was done. Classically, people use very elaborate sort of graft for this, jo pehle se bane hue hote hain, kai kai lakh cost karte hain, but we don't have that sort of thing. Patient was dying, so we replaced it with ordinary grafts and joined that and did olive elephant trunk with implantation of head and neck vessel. The end stage disease comes to you, patient with the large ascites presented with a myxoma, which was filling the whole of his right atrium and going up to the chest wall, and that was it. Congenital heart disease, you might have heard, it was very much in the limelight in Pakistan. The reason is that in Pakistan, the population is 180 million, and current birth rate is about 36 per 1,000 per year. Out of that, jo bachche paida ho rahe hain, isme se 6 to 8 per 1,000 live births जो हैं उसमें कॉन्जिनिटल हार्ट डिजीज़ होती है, दैट्स द इंसिडेंस. सो इफ़ यू कैलकुलेट देर आर अबाउट 60,000 बर्थ्स एवरी ईयर विथ कॉन्जिनिटल हार्ट डिजीज़ एंड आउट ऑफ विच 5% आर वेरी सीरियस एंड एटलीस्ट 3,000 to 4,000 बेबीज रिक्वायर सर्जरी. लेकिन ग्लोबल सिनारियो क्या है? ग्लोबल सिनारियो ये है कि पेडियाट्रिक कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट आर अवेलेबल 1 million पॉपुलेशन के ऊपर कम से कम एक. पाकिस्तान में कितना है? पाकिस्तान में अबाउट 8 कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट हैं. पेडियाट्रिक कार्डियक सर्जन्स 1 for every 2 पेडियाट्रिक कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट पाकिस्तान में बहुत कम है. अब शायद 8 हुए हैं, बंगज साहब मुझे करेक्ट करें अगर रॉन्ग हूँ तो. एंड पेडियाट्रिक सेंटर्स की भी कमी है एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इन 2003 देयर वाज लॉट ऑफ प्रेस रिलीजेस, फोटोग्राफ्स, न्यूज़ आइटम्स अबाउट बेबी गोइंग टू इंडिया टू गेट देयर हार्ट सर्जरी डन. नूर फातमा, आई थिंक दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल विल रिमेंबर दैट नेम, हु वेंट इन अ बस एंड हैड द हार्ट सर्जरी डन इन इंडिया. एंड द बिग हाइप एट दैट टाइम वॉज दैट पाकिस्तान कैन नॉट ट्रीट children with heart diseases. So everybody focused on teaching and training. Teaching and training of surgeons, cardiac anesthetists, nurses, ICU staff, perfusionists, physiotherapists and technicians. And that was fruitful. Alhamdulillah, today there are several congenital heart surgeons. Dr. Suhail Bangesh sitting here, Dr. Asim Khan, Dr. Munir Amanullah, Kamal Nasir, Multan is also emerging as a center. So we are not sending babies to India anymore. I think that people like Suhail Bangash, people like whose name you see here, are capable of treating all the diseases in Pakistan and are capable of doing most of the operation with safety here. So this takes me. Thank you. So this takes me to teaching and training of surgeon, and there are several cardiac surgeons trained by myself, my colleagues, Dr. Naqvi yahan pe baithe hue hain, Dr. Akhtar. They have made turn people's life by making them surgeons, and we also focus on cardiac anesthesiologist training. Public awareness program as far as training is concerned are also necessary, which from time to time the cardiac surgeons and the cardiologists do. But what are the challenges right now? The challenges are that people we train, paramedical staff, nurses, perfusionists, physiotherapists, everybody, they just migrate. There's a large number of perfusionists going to Saudi Arabia, Canada, doctors are leaving, nurses are leaving, and you know the reason better than myself. It's not just money. Now coming to cardiac transplantation, let me tell you, and a lot of people don't know about this, that we hear a lot about heart transplantation, but what is the fact? The fact is, पूरी दुनिया के अंदर 3,000 हार्ट ट्रांसप्लांट सालाना होते हैं. 3,000. वाई? बिकॉज यू नीड अ लाइव हार्ट फ्रॉम अ पेशेंट हु इज ब्रेन डेड. इट्स अनलाइक ऑब्टेनिंग किडनीज. किडनीज आप एक लाइव आदमी का भी निकाल सकते हैं और वो स्टिल जिंदा रहता है और ठीक रहता है, क्योंकि दो होती हैं. सो आउट ऑफ दीज 1,000 पूरी दुनिया में होते हैं, 2,000 जो हैं वो अमेरिका में होते हैं. तो वेदर दैट इज़ अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल थिंग फॉर पाकिस्तान, आई डोंट नो, यू हैव टू डिसाइड. बट वी ऑल्सो शुड फोकस ऑन ऑल्टरनेटिव थेरेपीज विच मे बी मोर फिजिबल. एज फार एज रिसर्च आर कंसर्न, डॉक्टर हसनाज शरीफ जस्ट वॉकड इन, हु हैज़ डन लॉट ऑफ वर्क ऑन डेटाबेस एंड रजिस्ट्रीज एंड ऑल्सो रिटन अ बुक ऑन दैट. एंड we as a society of cardiac surgeon are now focusing on accountability, on keeping data, and once you start keeping data, then you with the help of your data you can then think about cost containment, public education, your results, your effectiveness of care, your improvement, benchmarking. And there are various aspects of research in which cardiac surgeons are involved in audit, in reviews, retrospective studies, prospective studies, case report, dissertation, and as a supervisor for MPhil, MSc, and other degrees. There are some of papers which we have produced from Aga Khan Hospital, a decade of cardiothoracic surgery, redo coronary artery surgery results. This I did published in British Nursing Journal. So you can also supervise nurses, coronary artery bypass grafting, quality of life of patients in Karachi. This is a bench research, which is pericardial fluid and serum biomarkers equally predict ventricular dysfunction. To conclude, there are numerous problems and challenges for cardiac surgeon in Pakistan, and this specialty face this problem. But some of these are common in developing countries. The cost containment is a very, very big and major challenge for us. And a cardiac surgeon in Pakistan should endeavor excellence in clinical service, teaching, and research. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.